Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Today we'll be taking a look at the 4U Supermicro GPU SuperServer 420GP-TNR. This unit features dual third-generation Intel Xeon Scalable CPUs, plus support for up to 10 double-wide high-performance GPUs. Hit that subscribe button if you like these videos because we will definitely have more servers and professional workstation reviews on the back burner. But for now, let's focus on the 420GP-TNR GPU server. Outfitted with up to 10 GPUs, the SuperServer 420GP-TNR is designed for applications in AI, deep learning training, virtual desktop infrastructure or VDI, rendering, and high-performance computing. Choosing the right GPU is where you can deliver the best performance for specific applications. GPUs supported on this system include single or double-wide versions depending on your application and include a range of passive and active cooling GPUs. CPUs will also support certain workloads better than others, but the main purpose of all this GPU power is to offload the work from the CPU to the GPUs for even greater speed through computational acceleration. I mean, time is money. With third-gen Intel Xeon Scalable CPUs, you can install processors with up to 40 physical cores and 80 virtual threads each. The front of the 4U system is split horizontally, with air intake on top and 24 2.5-inch drive bays below. 8 drive bays to the left support Gen 4 NVMe SSDs, with 16 SAS or SATA 3 drive bays for the remainder, all hot swap. In fact, if you want to install all 24 2.5-inch drives, you will need a controller for the last 8 SATA drives, as the CPU controller will only accommodate the 8 NVMe drives and up to 8 SATA. If you do install SAS drives, you will still need a discrete SAS card for SAS support. A control panel on the left server ear has the power on button, reset button, and a few LEDs for power, hard drives, NICLAN 1, NICLAN 2, information, and a power fail LED. The last few LEDs are fairly self-explanatory, but that information LED can provide a bit more information, such as fan failure, power failure, and as a unit ID button activated either through the button on the back or through the baseboard management controller. Straight branding on the other server ear. It does look like it could take more storage on top, but Supermicro, like many other companies, does use the same chassis for a number of different systems. So in this case, no. Are you interested in the Supermicro GPU SuperServer 420GP-TNR server? If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off the price of a system that's listed on our site or one that you can configure that's valued at $5,000 or more. Just click that link for more information. When you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video to one of our sales associates. We have a handy little configurator tool to make it easy for you to configure the system. So have at it. Moving around to the back of the system, PCI slots on top with slots 1 through 6 on the right for CPU 1 and slots 7 through 12 on the left for CPU 2. This structure indicates a dual root system as you will need both processors installed to activate all PCI slots on the system board to take full advantage of the GPUs, with half controlled by CPU 1 and the other half by CPU 2. At the bottom of the chassis, 4 2000 watt redundant power supply units with an I/O panel in between. Out of the 4, there are 2 redundant PSUs for a 2+2 configuration to mitigate power failure. The I/O panel features dual 1 gigabit Ethernet LAN ports plus a dedicated intelligent platform management interface, IPMI 2.0 port, offering virtual media over LAN and KVM over LAN support. 2 USB 3.0 ports and then a VGA port and a COM port. Below that, what some call an OCP card slot, but Supermicro calls it an AIOM slot or advanced I/O module slot. Either way, it is still compatible with OCP 3.0. That OCP/AIOM slot offers an additional network interface controller without using up any of the limited PCI slots. Using the integrated RJ45 management port on the back of the chassis allows administrators to access the system remotely. Supermicro provides several options to manage and monitor your system, including Watchdog and SuperDoctor 5, SD5. SD5 functions in the command line or through a web-based interface. SDA5 also enables remote power on-off through the integrated baseboard management controller, or BMC. In addition to health status and inventory, SD5 is compatible with both Windows and Linux platforms and can also be configured to send alerts. The platform is compatible with Integrated Platform Management Interface 2.0, or IPMI 2.0, and supports KVM with a dedicated LAN. Other features help monitor firmware updates and power management. If you need a more comprehensive set of tools, allowing large groups of servers to be managed simply and efficiently, there's Supermicro Server Manager, or SSM. SSM is more for a data center application, while SuperDoctor 5 is geared more towards a target node. Inside the chassis, there are eight large 9-centimeter fans at the front, pulling in cool air and directing it over the CPU and memory modules, then through the GPUs and out the back of the chassis. That OCP/AIOM card slot can be outfitted with a number of options for network connectivity, including dual-port QSFP28 offering 100 gigabit Ethernet, or a quad 10 gigabit Ethernet combo port with two RJ45 and two SFP Plus ports. Several options are available for network connectivity. That AIOM module connects directly to the CPU with two shared CPU to CPU communications handled via the Intel UltraPath interconnect. With 12 PCIe 4.0 by 16 slots at the back of the chassis, five slots are routed through CPU 1 using that PLX interface, and five are routed through CPU 2, again using the PLX interface. Two additional PCIe 4.0 by 16 slots are connected directly to the CPUs, one routed to CPU 1 and the other to CPU 2. A high-speed NIC in each of those slots maximizes bandwidth to each CPU. The board also supports 10 8-pin power connectors for those GPUs and all of the connectors for the drives. Four each of the NVMe drives are assigned to each of the CPUs, although you will still need a SAS controller in one of those PCI ports if you plan on installing SAS drives. For RAID support with NVMe drives, an Intel Virtual RAID on CPU, or VROC, is supported. Standard or premium VROC keys can be installed offering RAIDs of 0, 1, or 10, and with the premium version, you also get RAID 5. An Intel SSD-only VROC key will also supply the same RAID values as the premium key at 0, 1, 5, and 10, but you can only install Intel SSDs. Those CPU sockets support dual third-generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors with up to 40 physical cores each. For a maximum of 80 physical cores and 160 virtual threads using platinum CPUs. Gold CPUs will support up to 32 cores and silver up to 20 cores. 32 DIMM slots are divided equally between the CPUs, and with 8 memory channel architecture, there are 2 memory module slots per memory channel. Memory support includes standard DDR4 registered and load reduced varieties, plus 3DS RDIMMs and LRDIMMs for higher memory capacity. Intel Optane Persistent Memory Modules, or PMEM Series 200, are also supported, at least with most processors, except for a few of the Silver family. With PMEM modules installed, you will have options for App Direct Mode, AD, or Memory Mode, MM. App Direct Mode will use the PMEM modules for fast persistent storage close to the CPU, while Memory Mode is just that, for memory. Each CPU connects to those GPUs through a PLX switch. As this system is Nvidia certified, optional for the GPU to GPU interconnection is Nvidia's NVLink bridge. Nvidia's H100 Tensor Core GPU supports up to 18 NVLink connections, whereas the previous Ampere generation will provide up to 12. With 18 connections, that translates to 900 gigabytes per second, compared to 600 gigabytes per second with 12 NVLink connections. Although given the H100 supports a PCIe Gen 5 interface, and this system has PCIe Gen 4, we're probably not getting the full bandwidth available from NVLink with the H100. CPU to GPU interconnection is via PCIe 4.0 by 16 dual route switch, which is a PCIe switch to optimize data traffic. Your choice of GPU will depend on many factors, including targeted workload, speed, and cost. That last one is always hard to rule out of the equation, but Nvidia does provide a very comprehensive list of options supported on the system that are sure to meet most budgets and needs. Those passively cooled GPUs in general are for high-performance computing applications, AI, AI training, that kind of thing. Those RTX GPUs excel at graphics rendering and visual simulations, basically taking your data and making it look good. For high-performance computing applications, deep learning, and the recently very popular and at the same time very unpopular because of the job-stealing thing, AI, the Supermicro GPU SuperServer 420GP-TNR can provide you the horsepower you need. Sure, it may be a generation CPU architecture behind at this point, but the performance offered is still profound. If you like this video, give it the thumbs up. We're always looking for new hardware, both servers and professional workstations, so consider subscribing to our channel. If you are looking to add a GPU server to your network, check out IT Creations, itcreations.com. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Thanks for watching.